St. John was a neighborhood church for us. I used to live right on the street over from Price, that was 8th Avenue. I lived there, and we would walk up to St. John a lot of times and would go to church when we weren't going nowhere else. So, but God was really good, so we didn't want to see that church just die.
Amen.
Amen. Sometimes, if somebody don't stand up for you, there won't be no standing too much. Amen. And we thank God for the National Church helping us out in what we were doing too. God is a good God. He's worthy to be praised. And we thank God for the members. I meant over there, but they're still doing.
Yes.
There's a lot to be done, and they're still going on. They put windows in here lately. I told them, I said, well, the district will give you a donation on that. And we did.
Thank you.
And all our churches in this area are poor churches.
Yes.
They are not like a lot of other churches. They're poor. And you call for a lot of help. And you got to use your head. You can't just throw away money. Somebody said, I'm stingy, but you got to be thrifty.
Yeah.
You got to use it in the right manner.
Yeah.
And because when you got just a few people, just so much they can do, and that's it. But we thank God for all things in Jesus' name, and God is blessing.
Ooh,
he is blessing. Yeah, and he's making a way out of no way. We thought about what Sister Regula said. Regular talked about getting a bus going to Louisville. Louisville was the diocese that I was over. And it would be good to go. But, you know, before we get a bus, if I'm heading it, now somebody else can be it. If I'm heading it, you got to pay half.
All right.
Isn't that right?
Amen.
Because a lot of time when you all don't know how it is, we have a bus. Folk write the name on the list.
Yeah.
And the next thing you know, they done took the name off.
That's it.
And don't cost a dime.
Mm-hmm.
And it's wrong to do things like
Amen.
That. That's why if you're going to head it up, you got to charge.
Amen.
Make sure you don't pay that half and let them know you're not getting the half back.
All right, now. Amen.
That's right. Now,
Amen.
So you got to know what you're really doing.
That's it.
Yeah. And we're trying to do a lot. We're trying to send folk to the youth convention also. We thank God, Sister Angela Rocker and her daughter.
Thank you, Lord.
Samantha and her son.
Thank you, Jesus.
They're all supposed to go.
Thank you, Lord.
This is something that, you know, I'm going to let the district help too and give it. And then we want to put on one or two programs.
All right.
In order to do this.
Amen.
Because you want to be a part of the church.
Yes.
If they let us know everything that's going on.
All right.
A lot of y'all don't know. A lot of times they be having little skits and other things, but you don't get to know about it.
All right.
And folks, if it's out west, folks out west come in first. Because you didn't know it.
Because
we got some of the best kids.
Yeah.
And they're smart. They're smart kids.
Amen.
I don't think you all know how smart they are.
Amen.
And I think it's right for them to let us know. I will talk to them. I'm going to talk to them. Let us know what's going on, what to expect.
All right.
When we get there, we don't have that many there going, but you know, we think that the young man that we're sending is smart enough to play somewhere.
Yeah.
So we want people to know that we are in the church, we're on the map, and we expect to do the thing that is right.
Yeah.
Because we all want to make it in the kingdom. That's why we are here. That's why we come to church, to continue to do what God has told us to do. continuation is, he said, forsake not to assemble yourself together. Then you got to live the life. You got to live a holy and a sanctified life. I don't care where you go or what you do. You got to be holy and sanctified. And you must do what's right. So many scriptures be coming to me sometime. Scripture that you know and I know too. Yeah. David said, thy word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. If you start sinning against God, then you're not going to make it in the kingdom. Let me go ahead and get through. I don't want to hold you too long tonight, but God is a good God.
Amen.
And he's worthy to be praised. I think I'm going to have to do it another way. I might just put y'all down to preach, because y'all, I've seen the one that going is here. And we got a list where so many ministers, you know, they have a week.
Amen.
They don't show up that week.
Right.
So we're gonna put the one down that is here. I might tell all of y'all to be ready that's coming. Get one of y'all. You know, it's not right for me to do it all. Because I can go out on the district and preach. You know, if I go into the place, most likely, I would have to take over the night wherever I go. So, but we want you all to what? Continue to study, continue to look at the church, because we never know when we might need a minister to go out on the district. Amen. Never know. So that's your teachers and your elders and your ministers, one by one. Everybody be ready.
Amen.
Oh, we got to keep it going. Is that right?
Right.
Amen. God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
And he's worthy to be praised. Amen. Tonight, we're looking in the Word of God. We thank God for all the things in Jesus' name. Thank God for all the ministers that are here. Our deacon brothers, trustees, mothers, missionaries, saints, and friends. Thank God for everyone that is here. Thank God that the church is still going on.
Yellow.
I began to look at other churches when I passed by the hall. I said, that's where the holiness people are now. They went to the Catholic Church. And they also went to the Jehovah's Witness Church. Passed by that. Their parking lots are full now after the pandemic. That's where they went elsewhere. Yeah. And thank God that Allenville is able to hold his own. God been blessing one leave, God sent another one. You know, so thank God. Sometimes you be down one or two, but God still sinful.
Yes.
And we have to thank God for it. Because you want God's word to continue to go.
Yep.
And the main object is to get people saved.
Thank you.
We want folks saved, filled with the Holy Ghost. Not worried about money. God have always blessed with money.
Hallelujah.
Yes. I can't think of a time when I was at Syrian, God blessed with money. When I didn't have people, then God blessed with people also. So we have to thank God for all things in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Tonight we don't pray for the whole year long. Looking in the Word of God, looking at 1 Peter 5 and 7. It said, cast all your cares on him.
For he cared for you.
For he what?
Cared for you.
For he cared for you. Quit worrying.
Mm-hmm.
Don't worry so much. Cast all your cares on him. Whatever been worrying you. Somebody here tonight must have been doing some worrying. You know, I just about worked out one message and then this one came. Cast all your cares. All your troubles. Things that is bothering you, whatever it may be, because God loves. text had online said, said Mike Law. That's what she meant, but they were low. I said, I said, right here. Then I went and I listened to the program. Sister Angie way over there. They were bigger than her better than me. I said, right here. I said, that's not supposed to be like that. I'm always trying to figure out things. That's been part of my job. On the job that I worked on, figure out things. But nevertheless, we thank God. Thank God that Mike is working. When we cut him up and let him stay up.
Right.
Let him stay at a certain thing and don't touch him anymore. I'm going to call a lady named Mother Tomlin. Mother Tomlin, she always listening.
Right, Lord.
There are people that really listen to our program.
Amen.
And we thank God for it. We know that the word of God is written out. Then other folk, they listen to other things all out of California. And your Sunday school, they enjoy that too.
Amen.
Everything we do, they watch it.
Amen.
Because we try to set a good example for the church. Yeah. I reckon God don't want us, the saints here worrying about nothing. I know that the Lord, he blesses.
Yes,
he blesses the church. He blesses the people in the church.
Amen.
Things happen because things are happening all over the world.
Yes.
Yeah. Folk get sick. People deceased.
Mm-hmm.
All that happened too, just right here. Because none of us came here to stay. None of us came here to be well all the time. When you get older, some things ain't gonna happen to you.
Hello.
I watched myself come up them steps. I used to get behind Bishop Ayer and push him.
All right.
And once upon a time, I think Bishop Mitchell and me were behind him. As we were coming up, he almost like he was gonna fall back, gonna fall down. But it seemed like he knew we were behind him.
Right.
And he kept going. So it happened. What happened to us happened to everybody. Don't be dismayed by the things you see, things that happen, and where things go. Don't let it confuse you, but keep on and on. I was thinking about our Easter program that we had was one of the best.
Amen.
No reason to hold your head down. Mm-hmm. Your children participated.
Amen.
And they did well. They tried to do what you had been instructed to do.
Yeah.
And you have to thank God for it. And there are some that put forth for another effort.
Yeah.
One that you all don't see. And they put forth that extra effort. They tried to do good in what they were doing.
Yeah.
And we have to commend them and thank God.
Amen.
Thank God for our children.
Amen.
They could be a whole lot worse. A whole lot. And they could be a whole lot better. And we want to keep on until they become much better. But whatever you're going through with, cast all your cares on the Lord Jesus Christ. For he cares for you. How many of you all realize that God really loves those of us who are at Adamville? God loves you. You ought to be able to see how God has blessed you. I've watched down through the years, God has blessed the church. He blessed you one by one. I looked at the record. When I look at the record, I said, God is blessing them. He's making a way for them. Things have gotten better for a whole lot of you all.
Hallelujah.
I've seen you made progress as you went. Amen. I've seen some went back to college. As they got middle age and a little older, then completed what you were doing. That's nobody but God.
Because
He cares for you.
Hallelujah.
He blessed you, you know, when your old automobile went out on you, quit running, then God bless you with another. Some people stop and never go again. But God has kept you going. And you ought to praise God for you. For all of that, He blessed you with homes that you didn't have, houses you didn't build. God bless you with all those things. And we have to appreciate God doing great things for us. Is that right?
Amen.
Why? Because He cares for us. Amen. Put it all in God's hand. Whatever you do, put it all in God's hand. Put it in His hand. Quit worrying about it. And He's going to bring you out. Amen. That's what I decided to do.
Yeah.
Message came to me. I said, well, that's what I'm going to do. Put it all in God's hand.
Yeah.
And don't worry about it. Let Him fix it, because He knows how to fix it.
Hallelujah.
God has the know-how to do it.
Thank you.
And sometimes He is the only one that can fix things.
Just
put it in His hand.
Amen.
Yeah. Quit worrying. Quit tearing yourself down. Sometimes you worry so you worry yourself till you get sick. And then you don't really need to worry. If we trust God, believe God, stand on His holy word. Amen? Because He will fix it. He will do it. I noticed down through the years that every situation that the saints have, sometimes that we have ourselves, God come in and fix it. He will do it. Amen. Amen. And that is a part of life. That is a part of life. Going through some things. But God won't let you suffer to the point where you cannot make it. Yeah. He'll lift you up, He'll bring you out. All right. And Colossians 3:15 tells us, and let the peace of God rule in your hearts.
To the which also. Ye are called in one body.
Ye are called in one body.
And be ye thankful.
Yeah. Whatever God does for you,
hallelujah,
don't be afraid to tell Him, thank you, Lord. Yeah. If you don't want to get loud, sometimes you ought to get loud in church. You know? Say, thank you, Lord. Say it, you know. Don't be afraid to holler out loud. Lord, I thank you for what you're doing for us.
Mm-hmm.
Be at peace. Be at peace with who? Even your enemy.
Yeah.
Be at peace with him. We don't wrestle against flesh and blood. Against principality and power, spiritual wickedness in high places. Quit fighting among yourself, fighting and pulling and snatching and going on. Don't be a part of it. God will bless you. Don't wrestle against flesh and blood, because that's not the real battle that you know that you're in. You're fighting against the enemy.
All right.
The devil himself. He comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. When things happen to you, don't think that people are doing this because they said this happened. You know, so many folk focus on individuals. But the fight is with the enemy. The fight is, too, that the enemy want to stop whatever the Lord Jesus Christ is doing. God is still doing things right now. He's blessing the church. He's taking the church to another level. Then the Lord want to see your loved ones and others that come to the church. When they come in, God want to save them. That's the purpose of the church, is to save them, not to raise money. You don't have to worry about money. I know it's God. God gonna bless the church with money. He gonna bless. That's all already done. That's a done deal. What we got to do is do what God wants us to do. Is to work so and try to save individuals, try to get them to come to the Lord, change the way that they're living. I got what I tell the folk now, if you don't want to be a good saint, want to be a good citizen. Is that right? It means something not to go to jail and be locked up 50 years. Huh? That means something. So you can lose a whole lot. You can lose this what God gave to you. Sure, we want to see you saved. That's the most important thing, is to see you saved. That's the most important thing that the church does, is what? Try to get people saved. But if you just done decided that I'm not going to do it, be a good citizen. Don't be out breaking the law, the rules, the regulations. Come and worship God and give him the praise. God won't turn your praise down. He won't turn it down. But you should think about where you're going to spend eternity. I'm telling you this, and not for you to slack up. At least you ought to be living a sanctified life.
Amen.
In order to be a good citizen, you ought to be sanctified. Amen. Sanctified means that you're not doing the things that people are doing in the world.
Amen.
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 Yeah, Mother Curtis and I be watching the internet a lot of times. On the internet, the folks in the world have what? Taken church a whole new direction. They be on there just shouting and carrying on, and it's not a real shout, you know. They done made something else out of it. Mm-hmm. Who can do it the best? I think about, you know, a lot of things that's happening in the church. I seen it in my young days. I seen it in school. We used to do a lot of things. They had a thing they called, and we all be out trying to do it, you know. And the teenage club used to do things. I never went to the teenage club about one or two times and almost got in trouble. Both times I went. So I just didn't go that much. But that's a lot of things you see have already happened. You just wanted to see it. And now the ease of in the church. It ought not to be in the church.
Amen.
Amen. And God is not pleased with it. And sooner or later, if I don't tell y'all, nobody else gonna tell you. God's gonna move his hand.
Amen.
He's gonna move his hand. Because he said, upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Bishop Ayers went a little further. He said that hell won't have no strength against God's church. And it won't. God loves his church. He loved the church. So what last week we preached about what? He died. That's why he died for the church. So he loved it. Amen. Amen. So when God does great things for us all the time, he's doing great things for you every day. You ought to be thankful.
Amen.
I better hurry on. I'm going to come on down tonight if possible. Amen. Yeah. Be thankful and be at peace one with another. Mm-hmm. And praise him. Give him the praise.
Hallelujah.
And always remember that God will give his glory to another. I don't even like to hear folks that say too many good things about me, because I find out that, like the old preacher said, the same, the mouth that praise you is the same mouth that praise you. And that's true. That's true. I watch that over and over again. Amen.
Amen.
Everybody's not like that, though. Everybody's not like that. Everybody get up and say that you're a nice person, you're all right. Some of them really mean it, but you got some, they change like a diamond plastic background wrapped around. to tell somebody about it who can get a prayer through. Make sure that's all they're doing, is praying about that situation. Isaiah 26 and 3 said,
Thou will keep him in perfect peace. Whose mind is stayed on thee.
Your mind is whereby?
Stayed on thee.
God will keep you in perfect. Anytime your peace begins to leave you, all you got to do is pull your mind in and get it on Jesus. Yeah. Pull your mind in. Start calling on the name of Jesus. Put it in. Start reading the word of God. Mm-hmm. Yeah. The Bible, of course, it tells us that he would keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on thee. Because he trusts in thee. That's who we trust in. Trust in God. Amen. There's no way that any human can have the power that the Lord Jesus has. None of us had the power that God has. I don't care what a person may say. Well, you know, I heard a lot coming up. Here one person said, I'm a friend to God. But God didn't make you a friend to him to do what you want to do. See, a lot of times people say things and they mean it for some other reason. I'm a friend. He's supposed to be a friend because he can do things and get away with it. Not for God. God is a just God. Yeah, he's a just God. And he means just what he said in his holy word. God himself obeyed his own word. If it's written, then he will obey it. Amen? Yeah. Sometimes folk don't understand God. They think God be changing his mind. No, God don't change his mind. That God would reach down and pull that grace that he had all the time. He would use his mercy. Sometimes in the Old Testament, he used his mercy. Sometimes he used his grace, you know. And we're living now in the grace period. This is the grace period, which is the church period. God, back then, grace was still there. Mercy was still there in God. And he would just pull it up and use it. Because he had that ability. God does what he pleases. He is God. He's the true and the living God. And whatever he does, he do it for us. Not mainly for him, unless he's doing it for his name's sake. He don't want nobody messing his name up. Mm-hmm. So you have to be careful about that. But he mostly, you know, do good for us. He is a merciful. I know so many things I should have went down, but God never let me, you know, hit rock bottom. Yeah. I was doing some things when I was in service. I said, I should have went to jail. I wasn't stealing, wasn't killing, nothing like that. But I was out of order. How many remember when you was out of order? Yeah. I wasn't selling drugs, yeah. I wasn't doing, but the things I was doing, I could have went to jail. But the Lord did not let me go. And I thank God for it. Kept me with a pretty good name. God is truly good. He's merciful and he's kind. Mm-hmm. So keep your mind on Jesus. Like they used to teach us in church. We used to hear a whole lot when we was younger in church. When you were younger, you would hear a whole lot. Keep your mind on the Lord. That's the problem today. Keep a mind is something everywhere but on the Lord. Psalm 4 and 8 said, I will what? Both.
Lay me down in peace.
And sleep.
For thy law. Only maketh me dwell in safe.
While you are sleeping, when you don't know what's going on, I'm in it like that. A By the time I wake up, Mother Curtis still speaks. I'm thinking I done heard something. She still speaks. So I listen a little bit more. Mm-hmm. I'm woke now. If I'm woke, I think, you know, I could do it a little better than her. It'd probably be better than her speak anyway. Because I think she's scared of me and her in the house. But I think, even why we are asleep, God keep us. There was times, you know, I left my vehicle open, which don't make a lot of sense. Mother Curry said, you better quit doing that. I'm not worried about it. God got it. And God did always. He always. God protect those who sometimes don't act right. Act like something kind of wrong with you. God take He'll take care of you. Amen. So I started doing a little bit better, locking it up. And then I know I got a alarm on it. It's gonna go off.
Yeah.
Then them cameras gonna pick you up and see who you are anyway. Is that right?
Yeah.
I still do some things that save. Mm-hmm. I think Bishop Trudeau was preaching about someone breaking in homes and stuff. Why is up there preaching that somebody was breaking in his house?
Amen.
He stole his deals and things. I told him before in the church. And for years I looked in other people's yard to see if they had the deals. He was one of the few that had deals like that. I don't think he ever found those. The enemy is out to destroy the saints.
Right.
One way or the other. That's why we have to be taught and we have to know that it's not individuals, it's not flesh and blood,
right,
but it's the enemy that you got to pray against, the enemy that you got to fight against. Don't let the enemy put it in your heart that one of the saints dislike you or hate you. That's the enemy trying to get you off track. You pray against that spirit.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Pray against the spirit. Yeah. And God will keep us in perfect peace. Even while you are sleeping, God will keep you safe.
Thank you.
I've been going to sleep 77 years. And God has kept me safe. He'll do the same for you. If God have done these things all of these years, why should I stop believing God right now? I still have faith that God will keep me safe. However, how old you are right now, God have kept you that many years. Oftentimes, Mother Curtis, she'd be talking to me, she said, yeah, when I was a little girl, it was, you know, the house was on fire, and everybody out the house but me. And somebody on the outside said, one more little girl.
All right.
One more little girl. This supposed to have happened twice.
Amen.
That she had told me. One more girl. And the Lord always got out. There she is right there. So God always got out. So God have done something good for you. If God done something good for you, He gonna do it again. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. God doesn't change. He stays the same. Romans 8 and 6 said, for to be carnal minded
is death.
Is death.
But to be spiritually minded.
But to be spiritually minded.
Is life and
is
peace.
Is life and peace.
Yeah.
Carnal mind. You know, a person who go on whatever come to mind. Some come to your head, you go along with it. There's a lot of times things will come to me, and I won't accept it. I just won't accept that. And the enemy tried to make it for real. How many know that? That's his game plan. To make it so for real in your mind. He keep bothering you and bothering you. You got to know how to be persistent. You got to be what? In a manner that you want to continue to trust God. Put all your faith in God. When it seems like that it is real and it's not. Something, it's something down to me, let me know. It's not a loud voice. Sometimes the enemy voice sounds loud. This is true. It's happening. This is doing. But that's when you got to really turn to God and trust God. Sometimes God will tell you, be still and know that I am God. Then he'll tell you to sit back. Watch it. How many know how to watch? Watch it. And don't dwell on it. Let him handle it. Because God will handle it. I mean, you don't know. Y'all know that. Sometimes when you're in a lot of situations, you know, I'm dealing with church, I'm dealing, you know, my home, I'm dealing with what others in the street, people on the street, they want to tell me things, want to talk to me, see, can I help them? You know, and so forth and so on. When you're dealing with a lot, the enemy, he'll try to come in when you're overwhelmed sometimes. So much going on with others, you know. And being who you are, if you're a saint of God, there's some of us have to deal with a lot of problems. A lot of problems. And when you're dealing with those problems, you can never let down to that flesh. You got to always think spiritually, man. You got to let God come in. You got to let him fix it. You have to let God counsel you. God settle you down and what have you. And make sure that you don't be making decisions that are crazy.
All right.
You better give yourself some time sometimes. Get that right? And just don't talk everything. I do a lot of talking. But most of the time when I'm doing a lot of talking, I don't thought it over. Y'all think things over. Think it over before you say it.
Lord.
Then if you say it and you find out you said it wrong, don't be afraid to come back and say, well, I said it wrong.
All right.
Get that right. Straighten it up. Amen. Hallelujah. But don't think karma minded. That's things that come to the natural mind. We go back to the word. David said, thy word have I hidden in my heart. We want to go on what God's word says. If God's word don't say it, that's your best counsel, is God's word. That's your best advice, when you can receive it from God's word. You be glad when God shows you in his word that he's going to fix it. This is how he's going to fix it. God will show you the whole situation. And when he does, just sit back. How long it takes. He's going to fix it. He's going to do it. Trust him. Trust him. Proverbs 3:24. Amen. The Bible says, when thou liest down, thou shalt not be afraid.
Yea. Mm-hmm. Thou shalt lie down.
I'm afraid when you go to bed, you're scared to go to sleep. Oh, we've been so tired, I had to go. But there are people that they're afraid to go to sleep. They're afraid to leave their home. Yeah. They're afraid they think somebody's going to come in and steal a little they got. You know, little whatnot. They got little whatnot. They got to steal my whatnot. That's what we used to call them. You know, little animals they done made. Little dogs. No, whatnot. That somebody gonna come in and steal my stuff. Forget about it. If they steal it, God is able to replace it. He's able to replace it. I'm not gonna call a sister name because most people know her. But sister was telling us, she said, somebody called and said, the house on fire. She said that. That she's supposed to get in a big hurry. It's already burning.
All
Right. And when you get in here, it's already wet. And he called the fire truck, and the fire truck coming out. So when I get there, and then I can do no way. You're not a fire person. You're not a fire woman, neither are you a fireman. So best thing to do sometimes, you have to talk to yourself and know something. Somebody, well, I want to get there and watch it burn down. I don't think I want to see nothing of mine burn down. Because you work too hard for it. If the fireman is already there, somebody can call them, forget about it. You got a problem. When the problem occurs, the next thing you want to do then is work your way out of the problem.
That's it.
Isn't that right?
Yeah.
Work your way out of the problem. Whatever the problem is. If they're going to lock you up for not paying the bill, go and pay the bill. You know, solve it. If you can solve it, go ahead and solve the problem. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah, that's the best thing to do. Hallelujah. God is a good God.
Amen.
Amen. When thou liest down, thou shalt not be afraid. I hit the bed. I'm going to put it all in God's hands.
Amen.
I trust God to keep me the rest of the night. Is that right? Some people go to bed trembling, wake up trembling. Nothing you can do while you sleep. So we have to learn how to really trust God. Put it all in His hands. And know that God can bring you through. God has brought me through, like I said, for 77 years. So I trust Him. Something may happen. If it does, take me out. I don't know nothing about it no way. I'm praying that I have lived in such a way that I wake up in glory. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank God. God is good. Then not only that, while you're sleeping, the Bible says that we're going to put the sleep shall be sweet.
Amen.
In other words, you slept real good.
Amen.
That's what you want to do. Man like Brother York want to sleep real good, so he can get up and drive that truck.
Yes.
So I think he drive what, gasoline truck this time.
Tank. Yes.
So you have to be on your. You ain't got time for trembling. you got to be just by perfect every day.
Yes.
Every day, and that's where you want to be. You need to have a sweet sleep. You need to sleep. I think Mother Curtis had more than him. Sleep all night. Get to bed, don't want to. In the moment. See you in the moment. Amen.
Amen.
God is good. And that's the way all of us, we need to have a peaceful sleep as we sleep. Yeah. Hallelujah. Psalms, I'm going to go ahead and close it out. I have a little bit more to go. Psalm 91:1-2 said, He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High
shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord. He is my refuge.
He is what?
My refuge.
He the one that keeps me. I know that.
Yeah,
he the one that keeps me. He is my refuge.
And my fortress.
My God.
In Him will I trust.
In Him. That's who I trust in.
Amen.
In God.
Amen.
When you trust in God, you don't have no worry. You don't have to worry about a thing. God is going to bring you through.
Hallelujah.
I am a living witness. Those of you who are not 77, you can believe what I'm telling you. If He did it for me, He'll do the same thing for you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God is a good God.
Yes,
yes, rest in the Lord. Do good while you're up. Do the right thing. Do the thing. Live peaceful with all men. And you don't have to be like the world. Sometimes when the world do some things, don't try to get revenge on them. Just hold your head up and go on and pray. Tell God about it. God will God's hand. Keep trusting him. When nobody else don't trust him, say, I trust him. Amen. You don't trust the Lord Jesus Christ, and you need somebody to help you trust him, come to me. You can believe I trust God. But all of my trust, my confidence is in him. I'm looking to him. Then we say, David said, I look to the hill from whence cometh my help. My help coming from the Lord. And he is a very present in time of trouble. Yes. Amen. Thank God for all things in Jesus' name. We hope you got a thought tonight.